Welcome back to Boxwood Avenue. I am so excited today because I'm teaming up with two of my really good friends, Julie Blanner. You might remember her from my last video talking about our Easter tablescapes, and our other friend, Sarah from She Holds Dearly. Sarah is an amazing friend and she's renovating her 1906 farmhouse right now. You've got to follow along. She shares so much beautiful inspiration. I know that you will love her. And if you haven't visited Julie's YouTube or blog yet, I don't know what you're waiting for. She is just amazing. You will love all of her recipes and entertaining ideas. So be sure to go visit their YouTube channels, subscribe, visit their blogs. And if you need any more interior design inspiration or entertaining ideas and easy recipes, be sure to visit my blog, boxwoodavenue.com. Today, I'm going to share our guest bedroom with you. When we first moved in, this bedroom was actually my mother-in-law's growing up. It was her childhood bedroom. So she sort of had her touch on it from when she was younger. So it had purple carpet, yellow walls, and a pink bathroom. We lived with it for a while, but when we renovated our house, we took out all of those colors. So now it's really neutral and it's really beautiful for guests to come stay. In this room, all we did was add some molding, update the flooring, and paint the walls. It really wasn't that intense of an update, but I think that it made a big difference. If you're looking for a really good gray wall color, I absolutely love this combination that we have in this room. It's classic gray mixed with bistro white, and it is so beautiful. The crisp white with the warm gray, it just comes together seamlessly. A lot of the things in this room are vintage or found, but anything that I can link, like the rug and the paint colors, I will put in the description below so that you can easily find anything that you want to add to your home too. One of my tips for styling or decorating a guest room is to just keep it clean and simple. Your guests are going to have their own things and they're going to need room on top of tables to place cell phones and chargers and any lotions that they brought. So just keep it clean and simple. Also, it's always nice to have a bathrobe or cozy plush towels. Slippers are a wonderful touch. Anything that you can make your guests feel extra special is always appreciated. If you've been following my blog for a while, you know that this house was my husband's grandparents. They built it in 1963. And when we moved in, we renovated and we changed a lot of things, but I really didn't want to strip the whole house of all the character and charm and the history. A lot of furniture I found throughout the ranch and in the house, and I've used it to decorate so that we really have all of these touches of history throughout the house. If you saw our feature in Country Home Magazine this spring, this room was inside, and you'll see that there used to be an iron bed in here. The iron bed we found underneath the barn when we moved it, and my dad helped us put it all back together, and he powder coated it and made it really beautiful. And I loved having it in this room, but this is our main guest room, and that bed is only a double bed, and so it really hardly fits two people. So when we have guests stay, we wanted them to be really comfortable. So we're saving that bed and we have it in a different bedroom and we haven't gotten rid of it. I'm still going to use it for that guest room. But for this room, since it's our main guest area, I wanted to have a bed that was really cozy and really spacious for everybody. The picture to the left of the bed is three of the brothers that were originally on the ranch. And the guy in the middle is my husband's grandfather. I found this picture in this frame in the house when we moved in. All I did was move it in here, and I think it's a really sweet touch for when people come to visit. It adds a little bit of history and character, and a lot of the time we have my in-laws over, and I think that it's really special to have that touch in here for when they stay. We have a storage shed out back that was full of a lot of junk, but some furniture too, and when we were out there sort of cleaning it out, I found this chest of drawers. And I immediately knew I wanted to put it somewhere in my house. So when I was looking for a little bedside table, I thought, why not add that chest of drawers? I love the height of it. And when we have the iron bed in here, the iron bed is really tall too, so it worked out nicely. But even with this bed, I think it looks great. I love the carvings and the beautiful marble top. It's such a gorgeous piece of furniture. And I think even though it's antique, it's made to look a bit more modern with the crisp gray walls and the beautiful crown molding. I'm all about finding inexpensive artwork, and you'll see to the right of the bed, I framed just some old receipts that I found when I was at a flea market in France. I think they were like probably 1 euro, maybe half a euro, and I brought them home and I added them into these frames. The frames are ivory and the mats are different colors of white, and I think that it adds a little bit of depth to it, but it was really easy and really inexpensive. And then you'll see behind me, I have this beautiful dough bowl that we've hung on the wall. And I think this just adds depth and texture and a little bit of warmth to the room. I love the way that all of the wood tones throughout this room sort of play together and make the gray walls a little bit warmer. And I love that I get to share this room with anybody that comes to visit us because it is so cozy. And that's always the goal, right? When you have someone come visit, you want to make them feel like they're at home too. I hope that you enjoyed this video. I had so much fun sharing this room with you. Be sure to visit my friends Julie and Sarah, and don't forget to subscribe before you go. And if you need any more interior design inspiration or entertaining ideas and easy recipes, be sure to visit my blog, boxwoodavenue.com.